I click here, I'll turn editing on, and I'll show you the difference between a label and a page. A page is the descriptive, elaborative thing on which one has to click and then the person enters in a page. Like, this is a page. This is a page, and this particular video has come as a label. Suppose I'm going to add a label here and a page. I'm going to the page, and what I will see is I'm clicking on page, and this is the description. A page module enables a teacher to create a web page. Please see, you create a web page using the text editor. So the text is a primary thing in a page, and one has to click on that page, and then the text gets displayed. As I have shown you, that when you put an article, in the article you can put things in bold, you can put bullet points, you can put a diagram also, you can insert an image. So whenever it is an exploratory, explanatory, descriptive, detailed thing, we put a page. But certain times when it is about label, so what label does is, a label module, the label module is, it enables text or multimedia to be inserted onto the course page. It comes on the course page itself, between the other resources and activities. Labels are very versatile and can help to improve the appearance of a course if used thoughtfully. Like, why they are saying that these can add to the beauty of your course. See this. I can add label. I can add an image to every module or every topic. I can add an image. I'll add an image here, and you will see that if I can add 5 images, these 5 images are going to help me a lot to create a very nice look of it. Suppose I do this. Now, description not necessary from my side. I am saving. Save and return to the course. I'll show you how this thing happens then. I'm adding things as labels now. So whatever is being added as a label will appear straight away here. So that way, this will give a very nice look. If you can, like, all these things can be added, and it will be appearing on the course page itself. Please see what I'm telling you, that all these are modules. All these are the organs of the body of your course, all these activities and resources. So we know that our heart is not visible. But if you, like, suppose our eyes are up front and people can see our eyes, they can see our face and nose, the hair is visible, the way our hands are visible, the nails are visible. So that way, these are the labels. We recognize people by the face, and the face is a label that way. Let me try the best speech sample. So suppose I'm going here and I'm creating this text as a speech sample, and just to read to you all, a teacher, the principles of teaching are self-enhancement, empathy, feedback, correctness in communication, inspiring the learners, integrity and the collaborative outlook, skills in educational technology, and creativity and innovative outlook. These things are required in a teacher. This is the blog which got published recently. What I'm doing at present, everyone, is I'm trying to add a Word document. So let me create a Word document and then try adding this. Or I got already the agenda, I can try that. I am adding a file. At present, I'm just putting sample, you say, content, Word document. I'm uploading a file, a Word document. I need to check it out. Why there was an error with you. Okay, here it is. I'm uploading a Word document, everyone. Here is the Word document, and I am saying save and display. So I'm able to upload it or not. Let me see. Let me see, best speech samples is the my is the subtopic, my subtopic. Yeah, it is there. So if the error was there, I would request that you give it a try again. And there was one more query by someone about URL and file. So can I request you? Someone was having an issue with URL and file. So you can please let me know if the query is still there. Otherwise, I'm moving on to the agenda, which is about Creative Commons. Any other query, please, or should I take it for granted that you are done with it? Okay, let me do a quick survey. One is Genomio. Two is edit profile. Three is customizing. What was that? Dashboard. Four was front page editing. Five was category. Course. Six was heading. Head. Resources. I have posted something. Please keep a look at the screen. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Type the numbers which have been understood by you, or the things you have seen and you believe that you might be able to try them with something. I'm asking the things which are clear. Clear doesn't mean 100% clear. Clear means that you have found them reasonably understandable. Making a thing on Genomio, you have done it or not. You have been able to understand editing profile. You have been able to understand front page editing, in which we went to site change, site home. Yeah, everybody is required to do it, please. Add activity and resources, create courses, get under the categories, front page editing. You can tell, or like if someone is saying number four is left, so please mention that four is left. Like there is one faculty who has said four. So I wish that I know this four is pending or this four is the only thing done. So please mention all 1 to 6 done, all 1 to 6 like not comprehensible to you, or number four is pending. You do this, please. Genomio, three create course category, Jayashree ji, okay. But you are quite near. If you have been able to create the course, then add activity and all these things are not a stereotype, but will be easy. Won't be a tough thing. You keep on keep a very smart eye on the things that we are having. Now 1, 2, 3 is clear. So if 1, 2, 3 is clear, number 4 is front page editing. When the video will be uploaded, you will be able to do that easily. Create course and category, if someone is saying that they have missed it, I would say they have missed a complete session that way, because we were talking about create course and category since we started the session after lunch, and just before lunch also we were working on it. Still okay. Akela K computer application. So the four number means, please let me know. Okay, it means the video which is going to be uploaded for you will be a great help. So you can rely on that for some time. Now, I'm moving on to the Creative Commons thing so that I can tell you what way you people can work better. We have worked on add activity resources, adding page URLs. The agenda for tomorrow is having actually the thing about quizzes and users. All six clear only when we put into practice. Yeah, it will be clear then, because as I posted just like before the session started now after the break, that please trust your mind. Don't worry. Keep a very smart eye here. The mind will do its own work. I know it is capable enough. I'm from communication skills and literature. I don't have any limitation dealing with the computers. It is just a matter of time. If you spend time, You can do anything. Like, it is not about being motivative, it is about being rational. So let's move on to the site again, and let me sign out and start again. I'll log in. I'm just giving you a gist of how I have done things. Login. This address was made by me. I got an email from Genomio. I guess I have closed the email now. I got an email from Genomio which said that your site has been created and this is the address. Premlata ji, I would appreciate that you put it in the chat. Switching to WhatsApp again. Yeah. Dr. Premlata, you have shared that ad blocker is there, so you need to disable the ad blocker. So ad blocker is being installed in your browser. You need to allow this site through the ad blocker so that this site opens some pop-ups or advertisements, though it generally doesn't do anything. Like, I haven't faced any trouble with it. I'm trying to log in. No, what happened? Okay. So, yes, landing on the dashboard. The interruption means the ad blocker has to be disabled for this particular site. That is the major thing that we all need to correct. Now, this is the dashboard and finding it out. Not everyone has responded though, but still majority of you. Number four is there. Number four. What was number four? Okay, front page editing. We'll do it. It's a matter of like 5-7 minutes. Somebody can project it in the morning and then like before we start the class, you people can self-teach yourself. My courses haven't come here. I need to find out sort by dates. Okay, sort by courses, nothing. Let me find out how the courses can come. Okay, this is course overview. I need to bring the course category here. Let me customize it. In the course category, it is visible to me. The courses are not active that way. Let me bring course category or reset page learning plans. I don't want. See, now I have got ICICI bank advertisement. Like, we teachers are the target of everything which is being sold just because that we are believed to be the most social human being. Delete course overview block. Okay, being deleted. I'll add the course category here. Might be somewhere. No, the calendar has to go. Latest badges. Badges is also a feature where you can keep some badges here, and these badges can be awarded to teachers, but it falls under the second level of a learning model. At present, for these 2 days, what you are learning is how to make a site, how to develop a particular course. Course does not mean a separate course, but how to put all your content which is required to be shared with the students. And the modules you are learning are file, the page, the URL, and all these things. So you customize your material, you divide your material in these things, that this is the URL, this is what I have got as a quiz, and that way you arrange it in a proper way, and then you make your students users, and then add them as, you say, participants, and then they get a password and user ID, and they people learn. So this is what happens. Now, where exactly is, I'm not finding the course category thing, and sometimes technology like doesn't allow you to do everything that you want to do the way you do. So fine, what I'll do is I'll go to site home. If my course is not visible in dashboard, in the site home then my course is going to be there. So I go to site home and then click on the course that I created. This is the course I created. No, we created another one. So let me get back. This is the one that we did not initiate. Every course will have its own topics, every course will have its own participants, but the site will have only one base, user base. That way, the user base will be only one. You can add 1,000 users and then can divide them in different courses. Public speaking is here. The image is still there. Yeah, this is the public speaking thing we were working on. Let me turn the editing on. Turn editing on. Yes, now just finding it out that these are the things. What are the fears? This is a label added by us. I can go here and then delete it from here itself. I can go here and delete it from here itself, or I can edit. And what I will edit is here is it is. The label is here, but now it is not add label, it is updating the label because it is there. So I believe the size of this thing is quite big. So what I have done is I have double clicked, go to display options. What I'm going to do is this 656 can be made 240. It's something like you just make an idea and you learn about these dimensions also, the width and this thing. Now this is what I have done, and then I have shortened the size of this thumbnail or the video, and then it will allow me a smaller space. Now this is what Manikshah's video has got. Article, read the case study, and these things are there. If you remember, we had added an assignment and the icon of the assignment is this one. So this is the icon. So please remember, if I am going to, tomorrow I'll be conducting a short quiz. In that quiz, these icons will be coming and you people will be required to identify that this icon belongs to which particular ad activity or a resource. And this is the summary, everyone. Here. Like this is assignment, this is feedback also which is available with you forum. Glossary we can do now. I didn't like do this thing. We'll do the glossary thing now. So let me do glossary. Glossary is, the definition is, glossary is a description of the specific terminology or the terms in a particular subject. Now that is a stereotype explanation I can give. Where do you want me to add the glossary? In the beginning or in the last unit? Like the last unit is best speech examples, or assessment is the last one. You want it to be at the end, or you want glossary in the beginning, or where? Please type it. I'll add the glossary there only. Where should we add the glossary? At the end of the course? Okay, right. So we are going that way. The glossary, because we generally add index and glossary and those annexures at the end. So let me go to assessment of the learner, and I'm going to add activity and resource. Before we conduct examination or everything, we are adding glossary. So searching for the glossary, I have found it or not? Yes, it is. Add the glossary. Adding the glossary. What is the name of the glossary? Glossary is GLOSS glossary, PUBLSE public speaking glossary. This is the description I can give. I can bring the description. Is this the global glossary? So you say global means, are we going to share it with the world or something? I click here and see what it means. It means a global glossary has entries which are linked to from throughout the site, rather than only in the course that the glossary is in. Only administrators can get a glossary as global. Now see, you are admin, I am admin. On your site you can do it. Now why I'm doing this? Suppose you are making a glossary which is, now let me take the easy one example then. The Oxford Advanced Learner's Dictionary has got the terms which relate to all the subjects. So that way there is a global glossary, one. Second, you are making a glossary which relates to organic chemistry, which relates to applied chemistry, which relates to another chemistry, suppose biochemistry. So chemistry is the global one. So you are making one glossary, and that same glossary will be added to every course that is running on the site. We are virtualteaching.genomia.com is my site. My site is running various courses, and I'm making only one glossary. But at present, I don't want it to be global because every course is going to have its own glossary. So I'm making it the main glossary of my course, and I'll say entries. I'll say anyone can enter the entry. The student can enter, and it will be approved by default. I'll say no. Student can enter. Student can contribute to this collaborative learning. If you remember in the morning, we had talked about the teacher has to be constructive, and we need to create collaboration. So what you do is you say no, it will, okay, fine, we trust the students, approved. And some more settings are there, you can see them, and then I'll say save and display. If I click save and display, I will be able to see it on the course page. And here the glossary is, and you can see there is nothing, no entry at all, no entry is found. I'll say add new entry. Now, the first term is, concept is what? The concept is PUBLIC. Now, this is just an example. PUB public is the people who come to listen to the speech, and they are also called audience. Now, this is what I have done as a glossary. As the explanation or the definition of the glossary, I can put all these things. If you remember, all these things, like you say bold, italics, and the link, the hyperlink, image, insert video, audio, video, all these things are same everywhere, wherever some content is given. Now, keywords, I'm not editing, or I'll say PUB, public. Attachment, further explanation, I'll say I don't want at present. One entry has been added. Let's move on to another one. New entry. New entry is, can someone give me a word that I can put it in the public speaking thing? Give me just that word and also give me what to write. I just want 3-4 words, be free. Okay, orator, who is an orator? Give me, I'm putting it, who is an orator? You type it and I'll copy paste. And then give me something about speech also. Agreed, you people want me to explain it. Okay, gestures, the one who delivers a speech. Very nice, you see, such simple things are required to be told. We need to specify it, okay? This is saved. Now this is called contribution. And when you will be student in the course, then also you can contribute. There was one more. Speech is the act of talking. Okay, taken. What is a gesture? I'm adding new entry, and the entry is gesture. And the description of a gesture is movements and body language. Fine, man. Thank you. Here it is. Now, suppose the same terms, and see, these terms can be linked also. I'm not doing it because certain things are required to be left to you for those 3 days also. Only practice, please remember, only practice of the same things will make your learning stereotype. Exploration is what you need to do. I'm leaving you people with certain things which are sort of temptation, and I wish that you people explore them further. Suppose I click on D. If I click on D, there is nothing. But you know, if I click on all, everything is there. Let me click here. You said gesture. Oh, great. We have got it. G. Let me talk about orator. It is, yes, it is. Let me talk about AUDINCE, if you remember what will come now. See, I had given the keywords. Do you get it now? This is what you people can do. If you like this option, which is giving you almost, I won't say you won't be replaced, don't worry. I and you, we cannot be replaced. But still, it is possible for virtual teaching through Moodle that we can bring almost everything of us there. See, what is this? Enter link, public. Copy. What I have done is, I tried to copy a link. Let me go to the course. I can use this link and I can, suppose I go to the, where is the page? Page. Okay, public speaking, importance. Here is the page. Let me see, experimenting just here. Oh, I haven't turned editing on that way. I have to edit the settings, means I have to edit the page. Here is the page. Here is the page and the word stage link. No, something else has come. Then it means I have to link it from somewhere else. Wait, we'll relate to it. Okay. If there are spelling errors, will it autocorrect while searching in the search? No, the see, there are two things now. Do we have to enter every entry in the glossary individually or is an option to okay. Question. Where is it? This is the message. Let me go back to PS. I'm just getting back to the thing. We can upload. Moodle provides you a bulk upload also, but for that thing, again, we need to move on to those features of Moodle where we need to learn something. Like, see, there is one thing also. You can give those items or those terms to Moodle, and you can easily do that thing. You can ask students to contribute to it. And there is one more thing called a CSV file. See, there are two things now. One is called a CSV file, and one is called a, what do you call it, text document. So these two things are required. What I'm doing is I'm just dropping the link to a very small video to the WhatsApp group that you can watch later, bulk uploading terms to a Moodle glossary. And you all are my fellow UC learners and teachers. You can explore it yourself. I've dropped the link how bulk uploading is possible. We are not covering that in 2 days because trying to venture into so much might make it a challenge for me to cover the things that we have planned. It is possible. The moment you say I want to do this particular thing, there are options. Certainly you need to explore further after having a very strong foundation and ground on the things you have done previously. Word document has been uploaded. Let me go. The query was bulk upload of glossary. Yes, it is possible. There are spelling errors. It will autocorrect while searching. No, it won't do spelling errors in like what? Dr. Jeshri, like spelling errors in the typing that the person does, or in the entry that we have made. We can upload as many videos as you want. The word I'm not using upload. You can link as many videos as you want. URLs, embedding in the same, you can do as many as you want. Like if this is one label, I can keep on adding labels. Or I can go to this and let me add, suppose I'm going to add a page, and in that page I'll be putting videos after videos. So suppose I go to YouTube, and I'm thankful that many people have subscribed to the channel. Now this will enable me upload things and then inform you also. So suppose what I do is I'll just open a few interesting videos and I will enter them. Now, this is about 7 steps of presentation. This is about PowerPoint presentations. This is about Vedic Mathematics by Buji. Now, pause. You can prepare your queries as well. This is one option. Mute. Now I am editing the course and going to add videos after videos. So description, I'm not adding anything. Description is description, a brief description, though there is no word limit in the description as well. But in the description, we give a very brief introduction of the unit, and then this is the content. In the content phase, insert video, this, insert. One done. Let's go to second, insert video, this, insert. This is third. No, this was the one that we need to insert. Third, this, insert. Now I say no, this is not just fine. I want to record a video of my own PC view. So you record it. The reason is that like this will start recording if I switch on my camera and I attach my camera. 2 minutes video is possible, dear friends. So there are different plugins that you can use. That is why I say upload it on YouTube, get a link here. Audio is possible. We are trying to find out how much content we can add to a page or into Moodle. Even in the description, we have added 3 videos, we have added 1 audio. We can add sort of like some text also, like if this is there, so everything is possible that way. I can do this, I can do this, I can make it large headings, I can give it bullets. This thing is possible. I go here, but I give it page. This is page loaded with contents. We have added a page. Let me go to display so that I can display how it looks rather than getting back again to. Now here it is, text, 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 video, audio, video, video. So this is, I guess, what the answer is. If there is something else, please do. Suppose, for example, orator instead of OR type ER, will it show? In the Dr. Jayashree, that way, when we people are adding the keywords, in those keywords, we have to add something. In those keywords, we have to add those possible errors by the students. Otherwise, the same way in a book, we write in the correct way that is being searched, so that way it can do. So these are the videos we have embedded. I'm going to the glossary again just to verify what Dr. Jayashree has talked about, the spelling errors which might happen. Like people may try to search it by wrong also, but the thing is the glossary entry can be connected with the words wherever they are. The same way Wikipedia has this thing that you click on it and then it is there. Suppose the word was AUDI. Here it is, ma'am. It will take us to the nearest one that we can give. The nearest one is this C, ma'am. I'm not sure about spelling error. You may not treat it as spelling error. This is about control F. So if you can see this, you can let me know in the chat. Suppose I put it here as, suppose ER, like this is ORATOR, and I'm making is the nearest letter to O is P. Suppose in place of O, I say P. So let me see whether it finds me orator through the parator. See, nothing found because the complete word is different and there is no similarity. But ORATOR If I have not typed O, still R-A-T-O-R has been searched in the glossary. So this is what is there. How to insert embedded URL video. This is what we exactly do now. Like we have just done it. Let me go back again then. So we were here. We were in the glossary thing. I'll go to this and I am showing you how to add a video. So the video is, this is YouTube. Open please. Yes. Public speaking. Suppose I take this song. This is a Nepali song, very pleasant. Okay, this is a playlist. I'll click on the link. Yes, it is. Let me go to this place. We were talking about how to insert it. Where do you want to insert it? You want to insert it as a label, or you want to insert it in the content? Can we install dictionary to check the spelling? This is Voila. Doctor, I want you to Google it. Dictionary plugin for Moodle. Let's do. Okay. Here it is. Uhu pop-up dictionary. There are different plugins. There are different plugins, participant learner. The plugins can be installed by us, but see, there are different plugins, different dictionaries and plugins, and all these things are there. Suppose I say diction, dictionary is there or not. So these are the dictionaries which are available. Let me share with you this link. Though you cannot install the plugins on Genomio permits only the plugins which are there. You can just activate them or use them, but when you are going to host Moodle on your own server, you can do what you want to do with it. Dr. Jasmine, what is the difference between inserting videos directly in embedded code URL? Okay, ma'am. Here it is. Let me go to YouTube. Let me show you what is embedding that way. Embedding is, embedding is in which you take the embedding code from the video and insert it. Embedding code is a different one, which is a programmed, I'll say HTML or that programming language connectivity thing. So that thing is there. Suppose I click here. And this is the video. When I click on share, I get options. Options are, I can want to share it on different platforms like these, or I want to copy the URL, or I want an embed code. If I click on embed code, it gives me a code that I copy. The code can be placed where the HTML thing is required. Like my, again, the computer science people can explain it better that way. So if I say that you are using a Blogspot blog. Let me show you this thing to you if you are talking about it. Tomorrow's timing is 10:30 again. Embedding thing on a URL one. Suppose this is the blog. Okay, I have to log in for that thing. I log into Blogger and can show you what embedding is if you don't know embedding. I just need to know this thing first. We use URL which is converted into an embedded type of thing. Live session is possible, ma'am. Big blue button is there, but at present they are not giving it for free. Live sessions are possible. There is one more plugin which is called Jitsi. Such plugins are there. You can explore them further. Live sessions are possible, but there are limitations. Certainly, there are limitations. There's a thing called API. So various platforms like software, the Zoom, or you can say WebEx or Google Meet, if they have released an API to be used into integration into different other softwares, like if they have released an API, then probably Moodle can allow us to do that thing. At present, Zoom hasn't allowed that thing. That is under requests or development. But Jitsi is there, big blue button is there. So you can explore it further. But big blue button at present is not active because of the load. You can go to big blue button and you'll find it. That is big blue button. I hope inserting you videos directly and embed code is URL. Inserting video directly, like you cannot insert them directly, you have to bring them somewhere. Either you will upload them, if you ask me, or you will bring a code. Moodle, you can bring a URL also. And embed code is different from the URL thing. So when you say embed code URL, I would say embedding code is different and URL is different. URL is the thing which is on the top here. Like you people click on a URL to join the meeting. Embed code is this code that I have taken from YouTube and I'm going to put it somewhere where this thing is required. Copyright means you cannot share the material of others. Copyright is that thing that it is being prohibited. So when I'm talking about say Creative Commons, I mean that you want to give licensing of your e-content. As in the morning, one of the faculty has made a document of 19 pages. You all make your documents, you all make your explanations and pages, but you don't put either copyright or any other thing. So let us talk about the permission. We call them what you all want to allow them. You want them to use it, but you don't want them to make money off it. You want them to use it, modify it as well, but you do not want them to sell it after modifying it. So these things are there. Now, what is copyright? Copyright, my dear friends, is the collection of the rights which are exclusively there with the author. And the creators and the authors, their credits are being protected by it because the people are the original makers of it. And why licensing is something which is important these days. You know Urkund, Turnitin, and you know the sudden increase and decrease in the permissions about the approval of the research project, some say 10%, 15%, 20%, 25%. The world is becoming tough for researchers that way because even if you use a word, suppose even the word chemistry is there, so that can also be counted. And there's a gap between the understanding of the people into academics and the people who run the plagiarism softwares in the libraries. So everybody is required to be on the same place, but still, plag check is something very important, and plagiarism is making people lose their jobs, to be true. And if I want that the creator should keep the appreciation, but I also want that the creator should allow me to use it honestly. But the creator says, what should I do? If I leave it open without any license, that doesn't do anything. I can't leave my home without doors. I want to put the doors, but I want to keep a doorbell. So if I keep a lock, nobody can enter. But I want to keep a doorbell so that someone knocks, someone rings the bell, and the person enters. So I had done a course, online course. I'll share with you people. I just got reminded. I'll share with you people about an online certification also on Creative Commons and licensing. You can just remind me, and then I drop the link. Now, why to allow CC? When I say Creative Commons, I mean Creative Commons is a system of alternative licensing because copyright has restricted everything, but we need to have something which can allow us to reuse the contents, something which can allow us to revise, something which can allow us to remix, and something which will allow us to redistribute the contents. And we need a license which will enable us to retain the contents as well. And you know that digital world has no walls, though we have seen that the geographical boundaries are quite strong. The whole world is closing itself to other world. Like if a country says that you people take away your people and give us our people, so that is the pandemic effect. But digital world still has no walls. And if you people are making notes, these should be shared as well, because education is, after all, it belongs to everyone. These things that you people have been using, Jamendo is for audio, YouTube is for videos, Wikipedia is for article text-based, Flickr is for images, Internet Archive is to download multiple things, like Vimeo is for videos. All these things are under Creative Commons. They are not copyrighted material providers. Now, versus the competition. The competition is, like, all rights means that the creative work is copyrighted and you cannot use it if this symbol is there. But and one more thing I want to tell everyone, and most of you must be knowing it, if the person has not placed copyright symbol, even then the person owns the right, if the person has even placed the name. Now, this is just a basic understanding. I'm not getting into the legal one, but if a CC is placed, Creative Commons licensing, like this is a category of licensing, Creative Commons, the world has got this thing. Yes, some people have shared and deleted the link. I'm glad that you people are looking at it. What is Creative Commons? Now, Creative Commons is something which is an organization. Same way, Moodle is an organization, non-profit one, and it is giving us legal tools. There are six different legal tools which are there. I'll share the link to the same presentation with you in the WhatsApp group also. From there, you can see this presentation again. At present, we are explaining, like, Creative Commons are alternatives. They are different licenses which are being given in place of copyright. Please remember one thing: attribution, credit, appreciation, it belongs to the creator. But if the creator wants to give some kind of liberty, copyright says you close the door, you lock it, otherwise there is no choice. Now, it is the level of sharing that you declare. You are telling me, Mr. Praveen, take this document, if you're using it, cite my name. The next day you felt that I have made good use of it, you say, Mr. Praveen, take it. You can remix it, you can change certain things of it, you can modify it, but when you are giving it to other people, you cannot make money off from it. So such you are giving me the levels of sharing. Level means that you are giving me less freedom, you are giving me everything. Now, alternative licensing approach is there. The world has accepted it. You can find it on YouTube everywhere. All everywhere this is visible these days. Now, Creative Commons, it allows you as a creator to share your work in a legal way, and you decide what kind of freedom you want to give to them. So please remember, it is not against copyright. It works with and for the support of copyrights. All rights reserved. Both these are friends. They are not against each other. One talks about liberty, one talks about restriction. These are the layers of licenses. And see, this is one license in which you please keep eye on the right-hand side, which is a black and white image. CC Creative Commons, there is one thing only: by. If this particular image that you see, if this is being placed there, it means if it is being entered in any document which is there, it means this document wants only attribution. You can do whatever you want to do with it. You make money out of it, you sell it, you change it, you remix it, you kill it, you burn it. The person just want, give my name, attribution is required, citation is required. Beyond that, from my side, you are free. Now, the second license, the first one is this, which is called CC BY. This is how you are required to remember it. The last slide will have a summary of it, and then you'll be able to recollect everything. The first license is Creative Commons. BY means attribution only. The second license is CC means Creative Commons. BY means attribution plus share alike, that you can. If this is being placed in a document that you have used or a video, they say you have to tell our name, you have to mention our name, and you have to send it further with the same license. Like you have used it, and then you say that now you are giving it any other license and you remove share alike. No, you cannot make modifications. You have to give attribution to the person who owns it. And if you are going to make any changes on it, the same license will continue. You can modify the vehicle, but you are not going to change the registration number of it. So the third license is by attribution and non-derivatives. Non-derivatives means that you cannot further distribute You cannot further distribute the modified material. You take article from a website, but and you can change it, you can use it for yourself. You cannot go and give it the modified one to your class. If someone has given this license on their article, you are prohibited from taking derived or changed materials, and you are not required to share it further. For personal use, you can use it. Fourth license is you can like use it, but you have to cite the name and you cannot make money. Non-commercial. You may not use that material for any commercial purpose. Fifth license is you can use it, but condition is level of you say freedom is cite the name of the person or the agency, no money, and share alike, no modification in the license. You can remix it, you can transform it, you can build upon the material, like you take something from Wikipedia and then you change it the way you want it, but you cannot distribute it further with any other license or freedom. You have to keep the same license which were earlier given to you. Sixth is by means attribution, non-commercial, non-derivatives. I mean to say no money to be made, name to be cited of the source, and if you are going to remix or transform or build upon the material, you may not distribute the modified material. Now this particular thing is going to maybe open our conscience and mind that when we take some article from somewhere and we modify it the way we want to do it, and then we circulate it to our students and we put it in the public domain, that is something which is unethical. Please remember, it is about unethical things. Now this is what it is. Basically, there are four things to be remembered: attribution, no derivative works, share alike, and non-commercial. And out of these four conditions, they have made six licenses. If you can see, first is public domain. That is means when a theta in the circle is there, it means it belongs to everyone. You do whatever you want to do with it. No one is going to ever stop you. So by SA, share alike, by non-commercial, by no derivatives, by no commercial and share alike, by no commercial and no derivatives. So means give attribution and share it the way it was given to you further. Give attribution, don't make money. Give attribution, but don't derive anything, any segment of it, and then send further. Give attribution, non-commercial, share alike. Give attribution, non-commercial, no derivatives. Now, those of you who were looking at the selection of Creative Commons attribution when I was uploading something, if you have found the reason, you can see why I was talking it. I was insisting on select Creative Commons attribution. Means we are putting it in the public domain, we are sharing it, and we just want the other person to please mention us. Most free are these. I'm requesting you all to use these three. If you are putting something in the public domain and you don't want it to be a copyright, please mention public domain. You have to speak up for the level of freedom you are giving, because there are many good people in the world. If you do not tell them, like I have seen my students, I have been a student, you have also been a student. You see, you must remember, you must be remembering, like it's not easy to forget. When we were in schools, we would not sit in front of our teacher, or in college, unless they say that please sit or do this thing. We won't dare to do that thing. And that is what we expect probably, like from our students also. And those who did do the same thing, we are impressed by them. It means there are people who are asking for permissions. So these are certain things. These are the same licenses again. And see, this is an example. This is my website. I have prohibited non-commercial, means commercial thing. Reason being, I've got content for communication skills, and I wish that if I'm giving it for free, other people don't sell it. And this website, which is a journal, Asian Journal of Distance Education, it says that Creative Commons license, give attribution and share alike. We don't stop you from making money also. This is a license example. This is a license example used by them. These are certain resources I'll share with you. I'll share with you the references also from where I got the presentation.